Hello, we will play some 10 ball, and we have a simple position here. Now we want to play position for the 2 ball. So we will just go straight up with the cue ball and start somewhere here. Let's do that. And now, what will we do now? Here, I like to draw it back for this side here. But it's tough because the cue ball will go somewhere here. So if I try to force it in by hitting the cushion hard, then I might miss the cue ball in the corner. So what I like to do is I want to shoot soft here. And if you can, if your table has tight pockets, then you can hit the cushion before here. But with big pockets, you can't. So it depends on the table what you will do. So now I'll try to shift the pocket a bit because with my table it is possible. Yeah, you saw that? I rattled it in. With tight pocket it is possible to hit this point before and still make the ball. But with big pockets you can't hit this point because it will rattle here and it will stay. So now I have an angle on the 3 ball. I can either hit the rail there and come back up, or I can go around the 4 ball. That is a choice also, but I might hit the 4 ball here if I try to go this pass, so I won't do that. It is also possible to play the 4 ball in the side or the 4 ball in the corner. So you have 2 choices here depending on where the cue ball will stop. So I will pick that choice because then I have 2 choices. If I go one rail up here, I have only 1 choice. So I will pick that choice, okay? Yeah, in the side is good now. I will play it in the side, and I will just make a stop shot here because that is the easiest, and then I have this angle on the 5 ball. Yeah, and now I can play position for the 6 ball. Here the perfect choice is to go 1 rail and 2 rails and then come up for the 6 ball. So I will do that. I use a lot of right spin and a little top spin. And now I can hit it hard and go 1 rail up for the 7. But when shooting hard it is more risky. So I like to shoot it soft and stay somewhere here with the cue ball. I will use a lot of the draw here, little outside spin. Right spin. Yeah, and now I'm on the 7 ball. So I didn't want to get too close to the 7 because it was risky. I could have missed the 6 ball. So now I have a longer shot on the 7, but I made sure to make the 6 ball by shooting it softer. So now I will go 2 rails, hit there, and come here with the cue ball. Here you need to look if you can make the 8 ball in the corner without hitting the 10 ball on its way down. So if you have this angle, you need to look. Yeah, I think it can pass, the cue ball can pass the 10 ball without it hitting it. So I will play position 2 rails and stop somewhere here with the cue ball. I use the left spin and top spin here. Yeah, and now on this shot I don't want to shoot too hard because if you shoot too hard you will create a 90-degree angle and it will hit the 10 ball. So if you shoot soft it will go to the side 90 degrees and then it will curve forwards to avoid the 10 ball. So I shoot this soft with a lot of top spin and left spin. So I want to go around here. Maybe stop here. It is also possible to go 1 rail, 2 rails and stop here for the 9. It is more risky to go back up here with the cue ball because the 10 ball is in the way, so you can't shoot that hard. So yeah, I will pick this path here for the 9 ball. I don't want to hit the 10 ball. Yeah. And now We came a little short, but we have a shot in the corner there. Hitting this, making this in the side is tough, but you can get the natural angle here to come up from the 10 ball. But this path is much shorter for the cue ball. So I think I'm going to pick that path and make it in the corner, and the cue ball will stay somewhere here. That is a good choice. And the man ball is also easier to make in the corner than in the side, because it is straighter in. Yeah, a little short there, but this can be made. Let's see if I can make it. It is tough, I can't reach so far. Yeah, it went in, you see? Okay, so that's the end of my video. Make sure to subscribe, and I will see you another time. Goodbye.